thought I'd just sit out here today and have a cup of coffee and chat with you because, man, it has been raining. And the reason you haven't heard from me lately is I've just been living my life, man. I was with the family at the beach with my two sisters down there and my wife, Meg, just getting stuff done. And I haven't had much to report hammock-wise. Sad. But I tell you what I am going to do here. I am going to make myself a cup of Vietnamese coffee. Hanging out in my Hammock d'Amour hammock, which I'm going to get back to later. Haven't been in this one for a while. And I do love just hanging out in this hammock. I'm testing out their new pad that they sent me, which is kind of similar to an Exped pad. But Exped didn't make up sleeping pads. I think Therm-a-Rest did. But if you correct me on that, don't bother correcting me. It was raining. I mean, cats, dogs, pigs, there were a couple of llamas. I saw an armadillo or two. I mean, it was raining some crazy critters last night. And I sat out in this thunderstorm under this tarp. And you can see the tarp that comes with this hammock is just kind of a, you know, it's just a regular open-sided tarp. And I stayed high and dry. There was a little bit of wind blowing. I didn't even feel any mist on me. The beautiful thing about this hammock is if you did get a little mist, you can just deploy your bug net really quickly and zip yourself in, and that helps with that immensely. This hammock is just a different hammock. You know, even sitting here cooking right now, I kind of like it because my pad sticks out and I sit like this, and you know, I can just put my little bits and bobs as I take everything apart here and get my, you know, my fancy feast out, and I'm going to put that right over here on my little nifty table that a couple of guys sent me, Tommy and a few of those guys from Germany. And it's kind of fun just to sort of have this as a little working area right here as I sit down low and I get ready for a cup of coffee. I have that stove stand stuck very firmly in the ground. These guys don't sell these. I just got it as a gift because I'm shook. And that is one of the benefits of putting out videos over and over and over and over, is sometimes you get. Often, I say no, don't give me. It's up to me to give to you. A spoon is one of the most difficult things to balance because it is short and it falls fast. So this is what the hammock looks like. It's kind of in recline mode right now. Water boiling. Open side tarp. You can think what you want, you can say what you want, but that kept me dry in a fairly blustery storm last night. And just before you ask me, that stand, it's hanging, that's my old hammock stand. They don't make that stand anymore. It's not made. There's other stands on the market out there. I'll even put a few in the description box below that are available these days. Kind of handy to have a hammock stand because, well, I can have one rig here and one rig there.
Yes, sir. I just had myself a pretty boil there. Yes, sir. Ain't you got no mama to boil that water for ye?
The only thing I can think of right now are, hammock-wise, are the things that I seem to get asked a fair amount. One is, Shug, if you could only choose one hammock, what would it be? Well, the fact of the matter is, I don't have to choose just one hammock. I have several. I'm a collector. That said, you know, whether you want a hammock with a bug net or not a bug net, whether you want a lounging hammock or a backpacking hammock, whether you want a hammock like the Hammock d'Amour, which is kind of a specialty hammock like most 90-degree hammocks are, I can't really say, but I have about five hammocks that I go to the most. And I may talk about those. I'm thinking about doing a video on showing side sleeping in a hammock. Now, I am not a side sleeper. I pretty much, when I get in a hammock, I lay there like a mummy. I may sort of slightly roll over to one side or the other about that much when I'm in one. But really, I stay on my back. I think what I'll do is just get out my hammocks and show me laying on my side in them. Give you my thought. I never sleep on my side in a hammock. But I'll tell you this, from what I've read and heard on hammock forums and other places, some people swear by the bridge hammock. Other people could not get comfortable on their side in the bridge hammock. A lot of people just, any old gather-in hammock, they sleep on their side in it. And then again, side sleepers have different levels of fetalish positionish. Whatever fetality they lieth in their supine or slightly prone position is up to them. So really, I can just tell you this off the top of my head, it's going to vary for everybody on side sleeping. That's just a journey you're going to have to take. It might take you buying a couple of hammocks. But remember, most of the cottage industry guys have great return policies. Get it out. Don't mess it up. Try a couple of nights sleeping on your side in it at home. You don't like it, send it back for a refund, and maybe then try a bridge hammock or something else. That's my words of wisdom to you today. Man, I am feeling pretty good about myself. A lot of you that have been subscribers of mine for a while know that summer comes, and summer, that's what I go out to my make my moolah. Eh? Money is honey, my little sonny, and a rich man's joke is always funny. That's my cash cow season, so I'm on the road a lot, all right? So I don't go camping much in the summer. I'm working, beating down this 60-year-old man. So there won't be a lot of videos. If I get a chance to go out for a one or two nighter, I will. And there's a couple of sporadic days in there in June I may be able to get out. I hope I can. If I do, I'm going to grab a solo and head up the Superior Hiking Trail and just get up there. Then I go on a very long two-week tour up in northern Minnesota. And then I have the Wisconsin State Fair. And then I have a couple of corporate shows. And then I have the Minnesota State Fair. So between all of that, that keeps me really busy in the summer. And this 2 weeks up north on this tour, that's 2 weeks of doing two or three shows a day, but not on Sunday, and then a fair straight in Iowa after that. God, you know, I am tired talking about it. I would like to thank anybody that has bought one of my Shook shirts or patch or mug or my Pretty Boyle shirt. Thank you for doing that. I'm not a guy that really needs financial support to do my YouTube channel. It's just something that came to be. I never planned to do a YouTube channel. I was just putting videos on YouTube to put onto hammock forums, and it became a thing. So the support is more, I just have to say, it's more emotional. It's an emotional support. When I sell a few shirts or stickers or a mug, it pumps me up to do a video. Because I've been doing this a long time, and sometimes I gotta say, it's just a lot of work and you gotta get yourself to do it, because it's not my job. It is just a passion. This is like me mowing lawns for a living. I raise my Foster's putt to you and have a sip. So here's another thing about my channel. From time to time, I will be putting a control line airplane video on my channel, because it's a dying hobby. And just like hammock camping or backpacking, most of you are excited by that. I do have a fair amount of people that like to watch the control line videos. Now, I know most of you don't. I do it for my own pleasure. You know, I can only film my life. So let me just say this. If you don't like those videos, if you don't like when I upload a control line video, just please don't watch it. You don't have to watch it and then tell me that it wasted your time. Just don't watch it. You're not going to hurt my feelings by not watching it. It hurts my feelings more when you tell me I wasted your time or it's a lame hobby when I don't find it lame, okay? So that's going to happen from time to time. It's not going to take over the channel, but I'm trying to keep that hobby alive. And by me having the videos on there, there are some old retread guys and some guys that are coming back to control line or just see me having fun with it. Control line speaks to a part of me, memories of my father. I like the connecting to the airplane. I like competing in it. It's just a hobby I love to do. I can go out for 4 or 5 hours, have a great time with it, and just kind of mess around and dink around with the airplanes in my shop. I got to get a little bit whiny on you here. Now I'm going to tell you about this shoulder. So I went and had an MRI, ortho, where they shoot this stuff into your shoulder and can see the shoulder joint here. I've been having pain in it for the last 6 months. I have a lot of trouble reaching back, and what I have is a rotator cuff injury. I have two tears in my glenoid labrum, which is a, sounds dirty, doesn't it? My glenoid labrum. Yo! That's my rap name. Hey, everybody, yo! I'm glenoid labrum. What's going on, y'all? So that is a cartilage that goes around your ball and socket joint here in your shoulder. So if this was the top of my arm, my humerus, going into that joint, there's a ring of cartilage, well, actually goes around here. And mine is torn in the back in two places, all right? And also my top muscle. I think it's my suprascapulitum, which is the muscle right over the top. I have a 90% tear in the tendon there. These are not unusual injuries, particularly for a circus person, for somebody my age, 60 years old, just turned 60, and I feel every bit of it. Years of doing circus, a lot of it I think is from doing my unicycle face fall, where I fall flat on my face on my unicycle, and I make it sound painful. I mean, it's years of hitting, and you get a thrusting action back. There's some impact there. Thousands of millions of clown falls doing face falls. It's caught up with me. I have to get surgery to get it fixed. Otherwise, this muscle on the top could pop, and then it's gonna be serious to get it fixed. I told them I want to get through my summer of doing my show, so I'm taking the unicycle face fall out, so I got to figure out a different place to spit those teeth. It pains me to do that. I'm not comfortable with modifying at all, but I'm getting to that age, so I'm going to do it, so I'm not taking that hard impact. Most of my juggling feels fine. I just have to watch the high impacts and things over my head, which I don't have a lot of, to be honest. So if I can get through this summer and not snap this thing and have this muscle pop and go back behind my neck, and then they got to cut me open and dig it out. And I hope that don't happen, because that sounds like that's going to suck. It's going to be 8 to 12 weeks in a sling afterwards. So I won't be working after the state fair. The first 4 or 5 months are going to be critical. But it's a year recovery. But that said the same thing when I had my knee surgery. I'd say a year to get kind of normal. Really 2 years to get really good. So that's the word on that. I'm not too worried about it, man. I could use a little downtime. My arm hanging there. I don't know. I got to practice kind of getting my hammock up with one arm. But really, that's all I got to talk to you about today. And I appreciate you listening. I was feeling kind of chatty, and I've missed y'all. Most of you are just been great subscribers and viewers, and I appreciate it so much. Okay, all that talking just exhausted me, so I got to lay down.